Welcome! Right now we're going to go through an example of finding the linear regression line using the TI-89 calculator. Now it sounds like a complicated process, but the good news is it's actually not so bad. But there are a few things that we want to make sure we do. One, we're going to enter all of this data into the calculator. Two, we're going to make sure that the calculator does all the heavy lifting and calculates that linear regression line. And three, we're going to take a look at the data it gives us and interpret it as best we can. Okay, so watch what buttons I press in order to accomplish this. Okay, so go ahead and grab your calculators and let's get to work. All right, so the first thing I need to do is get all of this data into the calculator. In order to do that, I need to find my data matrix editor. So from the home screen, I'm going to press apps, and then I'm going to scroll over until I have that data matrix editor selected. Okay. Now once you have that, press your enter key. Now it doesn't bring you immediately to the data matrix editor. Instead, we've got to enter in a few things. The first thing I want to know is this going to be a new list? Is it going to be one you've been working on? And for our purposes, let's make an entirely brand new list. So I'm going to scroll down until I have new selected and then press enter. All right, now we have a few more options to enter. First one wants to know what type of data this will be. This is going to be a list. So I'm going to press my right arrow and then scroll down to list and then press enter. All right. The next option says folder, and this basically wants to know where we're storing the information. Right now it's set to the main folder, and we're just going to leave it as the main folder. All right, one last option. It wants to know what we want to call this list, the variable name. You can pretty much give it whatever name you want, you know, don't have to be really picky. But just for, you know, keep things nice and simple, I'm going to call my list E. You'll notice that the alpha lock was already on, so I just had to press the E button. All right, once all that is entered, press enter, and then press enter one more time. Okay, so this brings you into the data matrix editor screen, and it looks a lot like an Excel sheet or something. So what we're going to do is start entering in all of our data, and we do it one column at a time. So 0, enter, 1, enter, 2, enter, 3, enter, 4, enter. There you have it. I'll use my arrow buttons to start the next column, and I'll enter in my Y values. 6.4, 8.6, 11.5, 17.8, 18.4. There you have it. So we have all the data entered in. Now, take note of this, it will be important later on. At the top of each of these columns is a name. At the top of my columns it says C1, and on top of the other column it says C2. This will be important. Alright, so all of our data is in the calculator. It's time to make it find the linear regression line. In order to do this, I want to go to my calc menu. So you can see it near the top here, it says F5 calc. So go ahead and press your F5 button to get into that menu. Now a lot of things pop up, it gets real confusing. That's okay. The first thing it wants to know, well, what calculation do you want to do? Right now it's set to 2 variable, so let's press our right arrow button and see what options we have. Now a lot of these are regression lines. But since we want the linear regression line, scroll down to that number 5 option. It'll say LINREG for linear regression, and make sure that is selected. Okay, press enter. Okay, now that the calculator knows that we're doing a linear regression, it wants to know what data we're going to use. So the next two options, when I scroll down, will be to enter what the X values are and the Y values. Now remember, these are already stored inside the calculator. So what I'm going to tell the calculator is to look at list C1 and C2. All right? So let's do C, and then I'll hit 1, go down to the next one, and press C. C, and looks like 2. All right. So the calculator says, our X data is in C1, Y data is in C2. Perfect. Now a third option that you can do, it's a really good idea, is if you scroll down one more time, it says store regression to, and then it's set to none. Go ahead and select this, press your right arrow button, and select Y1. What that option is going to do is after the calculator is done finding the linear regression line, it will store it into our Y equals screen as equation 1. All right. So basically we have the calculator all set up. It's time to make it find the line. Go ahead and press enter. And a menu pops up with lots of different values. The first thing it has written on there is y equals ax plus b. That's how we know it's a linear regression because it's showing us a line. And then it gives us some values for a, 3.32, some values for b, 5.9, and the correlation coefficient, 0.973477. Okay, so the way we want to interpret this data is the a and b becomes the slope and the y-intercept of the line. So it's basically built this equation, y equals 3.32x plus 5.9. Just like that. And so this is the linear regression line we are looking for. That correlation coefficient that it's giving us is telling us how good a fit the line is to the data. The closer the correlation coefficient is to 1, the better the data fits. The closer it is to 0, then the line is not such a good fit to the data. All right, and there you have it. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.